On the 6th of October, 1973, Egypt and Syria launched the Yom Kippur War. The war was one of the most difficult in which the IAF has taken part. The IAF was not able to launch a preemptive strike. During the first phase of the war, the IAF's task was to block the Egyptian and Syrian forces that had crossed our forces' front lines at the Suez Canal and in the Golan Heights. Thanks to IAF pilots, no enemy aircraft succeeded in penetrating the State of Israel's airspace. This would have disrupted the general call-up of the reserves, which were desperately needed on the front. However, the IAF paid a heavy price for protecting the skies. In a single day, on October 7th, six IAF jets were hit on the Syrian front. In contrast, in the Suez Canal zone, the IAF succeeded in paralyzing Egyptian anti-aircraft batteries. 32 Egyptian missiles were destroyed and another 11 damaged. 11 additional batteries were destroyed by IDF tank and artillery forces after the canal had been crossed. When the IDF began to counterattack, the IAF joined in on both the Egyptian and Syrian fronts and destroyed many jets on the ground and completely disrupted enemy air force operations. On the 9th of October, in retaliation for the launch of surface-to-surface missiles against civilian Israeli targets, the IAF attacked the Syrian army headquarters situated in the heart of Damascus. Helicopters played a very active role in the war, rescuing many pilots caught behind enemy lines even while under fire. The helicopters transported assault troops behind enemy lines as well as cannons in Jebel Atqa. They were able to reach Golani troops on the Hermon, which had been recaptured by the Syrians. The anti-aircraft forces proved themselves in battle and downed dozens of enemy aircraft. 300 Egyptian jets and more than 150 Syrian jets were shot down during the war. The IAF's air combat one-loss record for 1973 was twice as good as it had been during the Six-Day War. However, the price was very high. Approximately 100 IAF jets were shot down. Close to 60 pilots and navigators were killed, and many pilots were taken captive.